Appalachia has been recognized as a national area of water inequity, particularly in central Appalachia and southwest Virginia and southern West Virginia. Rural areas are typically more likely to have inadequate water supplies, whether it's centralized plants that don't meet safe drinking water requirements or people who don't even have access to municipal water supplies. So doing this research, it's helpful for people here. It's also highlighting the issues that still exist in lots of parts of rural America. So we started monitoring these springs about 5 or 6 years ago because they're a common place for community folks to get water. This is the water that people rely on in their home for cooking and drinking. And there's no one testing the quality. These are just total environmental sources. So the most common water quality problem that we find in these springs is the presence of fecal indicator bacteria like E. coli, which could mean that there's a risk of gastrointestinal illness. So we've been monitoring the springs. We maintain a website with information on the springs.
We are collecting samples both at a spring, and we're collecting bottled water samples in order to test for general water quality contaminants. My experience being out here and especially engaging in water quality research, especially in the field, it's very meaningful to see how people live and how we can offer them the best results in order to make an informed decision about how they're going to collect their water.
I'm learning a lot about the scientific aspects, so like the water quality and contaminants involved in that. And then I think I'm learning a lot about the social impact as well, and how different communities rely on something so fundamental as drinking water. That was definitely something that I was looking for in my education, was actually being in the field and getting to meet the people and work with the people that I will ultimately and hopefully have an impact on.
We all have this perception of universal access in America. And students come to Virginia Tech and they learn it's a lot more complex. It's not just a technical issue. There's political issues, sociological issues. There are tons of places that they can contribute and that are all important. And ideally, work like this, illustrating the risks and also just the effort and the pervasiveness of needing to rely on sources like this, will encourage more investment in centralized water infrastructure that meets health-based guidelines.